Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this video presentation from Build Bangladesh Foundation. Today we are here to have a little discussion with the very famous and illustrious designer, Ms. Sarah Karim, who's a wonderful entrepreneur, and also she was a faculty member at North-South University, and there was the list of her accomplishments goes on, and she does a lot of CSR work as well. So it's a great pleasure and honor to be here, and we're very thankful that she was able to give us time. So, and I'm joined here today by other fellow core members of our founding team of Build Bangladesh Foundation. I have Farhanaz over here. She used to work for the United Nations, and she's one of our core founder members. We've got Asan Bhai. He's heading the compliance department in one of the leading apparel international brands, which sources out of Bangladesh. We have with us Shakil Bhai over here, just beside me. I don't want to overlook him. Shakil Bhai is heading, he's the COO of a large local corporate group. And we have Mahbub Bhai, who's heading the HR in DHL. So we've got a pretty interesting, diverse group of professionals over here, as you can see. And our whole organization is comprised of professionals and entrepreneurs. And what we do is we brainstorm ideas, and we try and pass that on to policymakers and decision makers to try and contribute towards making Bangladesh just a little bit better. So that's how we want to contribute towards building Bangladesh. So thank you very much for joining us. And I just want to know, how do you feel about an organization like this coming into existence? We just launched a few months ago.
I think it's fantastic, because I think there must have been a gap existing there, mm-hmm. Because the politicians and your policymakers, obviously there's a gap between what they think that people need and what mm-hmm. they really need. So I think it's a wonderful initiative, and you guys really need to do this. So hopefully that I hope you find success.
thank you so much, because I think that is an area, what you exactly said, that from what general people are thinking and from what the policies are actually being made, there is a bit of a gap over there, and we just want to fill up that niche, actually. So we would also like to have you amongst us as an advisor. How do you feel about that?
Honored, and I hope that I can contribute. But the area that I would probably want to emphasize would be education. Mm-hmm. Children's education, mm-hmm. and also what we do with Thrive, which is that we feed these slum children, and mm-hmm. The thing about them is that there's so much potential in them, mm-hmm. and if you just nurture that, mm-hmm. we can have this huge force of people, mm-hmm. who are youngsters, who are so talented, and they've got different. So we really need to encourage them to come into the mainstream, finish their education, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. and the little bit of nourishment that we bring them every day is, I think, important. So these are little things.
Exactly, and that is exactly something that I would like to talk a little bit more about, because I mean, one of the things that we want to also promote through Build Bangladesh Foundation is CSR. We want to promote the government making policies that encourage more CSR, and we also want to promote organizations doing more CSR. And I think what you're doing is really fantastic. And can you tell us a little bit more about Thrive? Like, how many kids are you feeding daily? How long has this program been going on?
So this was basically started in, I think, 2012. So mm-hmm. it's been happening for about 6 years now. And it was actually started, surprisingly, by two expatriate ladies, mm-hmm. who actually saw that, there were these children, they were hungry on the streets, mm-hmm. So they started in a very, very small way by just bringing a banana, some peanuts, okay. mm-hmm. a fruit and an egg to one of the schools that, mm-hmm. and since then we now, I think, cater to about six or seven very large schools, about 1,000 children every day, and we actually go to the schools. So these are schools which are free schools, they are slum schools, but a lot of children would of course leave because there was no incentive to stay, yeah. or mm-hmm. the parents would rather that they're begging on the road, right. or they're earning something. Mm-hmm. So this way, of course, the fact that they get a free meal is a big incentive for them.
Okay. Fantastic. So,
and now, of course, it started with those two ladies, American ladies in fact, but now, of course, it's come down. A whole lot of us are now involved, and I I think it's working very well. We've actually got, we do have a donation, we get donations from abroad, but mm-hmm. also a lot of companies, okay. You know, in Bangladesh who are sort of, you know, helping out. But I think what we need is something which is more stable. Mm-hmm. So, you know, okay. if companies could say, you know, guarantee that, you know, for this 1 year they would give us, even if it's 10,000 or 15,000 mm-hmm. or 20,000, mm-hmm. but that they would give it every month for say a year or
right.
say 2 years.
So currently, I guess it's just a piecemeal sort of a thing that's going on. Sometimes yes. they feel like giving. So yeah. you want.
No, we do have mm-hmm. a couple of companies that have been with us right mm-hmm. from the start, and they give a very substantial amount. Remember, okay. it's actually a lot of money.
It is.
It's, you know, feeding a thousand,
that's
a huge lot of money.
It's actually a lot of money. Mm-hmm. So it does, you know, it, mm-hmm. people have contributed in large amounts. And mm-hmm. it's been, you know, we have a couple of companies that also Direct Fresh mm-hmm. actually supplies the food to the.
Wow.
Yeah. And they, of course, give it as a slightly subsidized rate.
Right, right.
They also partner with us.
So, any suggestions that you would like to give to the audience and to, I'm sure, a lot of entrepreneurs who are watching as well about, you know, CSR and why they should do more CSR?
Well,
sorry.
Well, another thing, in fact, this is now a registered, Thrive is now a registered, you know, mm-hmm, sort mm-hmm. of
entity
charity,
organization.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
A charity where, you know, anybody who contributes gets a listing in our, you know, on our website, mm-hmm. on our official sort of, you know, mm-hmm. Documents, or if there's a live program, they will get mm-hmm, a mention. Mm-hmm. So, you know, and the reason to do it would really be because, you know, we're living in one of the poorest countries in the world, and mm-hmm. I think that everybody must make their little bit of contribution.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So if there is an amount which you have, you know, or if you can afford to, I think mm-hmm. all of us need to do our bit. So we're not asking for a lot of money.
Exactly.
Even if it's just a small amount, if you think that, mm-hmm. you know, and
I think that is one of the main messages that we are also trying to promote from Build Bangladesh Foundation regarding CSR, that if everyone actually contributes a little amount of money, then that can, I mean, everybody does a little bit of CSR, then that actually accumulates into a very large amount.
Money, sometimes
in kind support.
A lot of people, you know, sort of just go there with the food and
all
just
right.
interact with the children. Mm-hmm. A lot of ladies actually do that. A lot of young school children, in fact, do it as part
okay.
of their, you know, community
really nice.
Service.
That's
so
wonderful.
And they interact with the children. All of that, you know, helps them just be in a happier
exactly.
place.
True.
Yeah. In fact, I have lots of, later if you want, some, mm-hmm. I can send you some pictures.
Yes,
of
I think that would be, that would be really wonderful. So we were, in Build Bangladesh, there are also some other agendas that we have been talking about, such as the vision for Bangladesh. So if you would like to.
Yes, thank you, Kasad Bhai. So we'd like to hear from something from you, Sara, that because you're involved in a CSR project, and I'm sure that you have some vision. You want to do something better for the country in a more constructive way. So one of the things that in Build Bangladesh, what we are doing is we want to know from people like you, what are your visions and how actually we can, you know, collaborate with you and make it more forceful and interactive and also effective for the country.
Okay.
So vision for Bangladesh.
Okay, one of course is what I spoke about, which is the education, which is really mm-hmm. thrive. The other one would be more closely associated with what I do as a business, which mm-hmm. is, the
fashion design
mm-hmm. the clothes that I do. And I want to, you know, sort of also focus a little bit on the artisans who work for us.
Right.
And also the fact that they are so talented. They're no mm-hmm. less talented than, mm-hmm. you know, than
right.
mm-hmm. the
very
ones
very
you
much.
Find in India or in Pakistan. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, most of the, you know, people buy clothes which are really not made here. It's coming from, you know,
true.
All over
true.
The place. But I think that if all the, you know, at least, you know, people who are in the business and who, mm-hmm. you know, sort of buy clothes,
right.
buy the thiki and ethane ishe, they just mm-hmm. retail it. If they actually spent a little time in developing, you know, your local mm-hmm. crafts and, you know, or, you know, sort of mm-hmm. Just highlighting.
So in your vision, you want to do something better for them. I mean, how you want to do that?
Just by giving them employment, you know, okay. really not, we don't really need to do them any favor. They're so talented, but mm-hmm. somebody needs to give them the work.
Mm-hmm.
You have to
mm-hmm.
say that, you know, and you have to be fair. Like, you know, in my in my business, I think I can safely say that I pay my craftsmen very well. Mm-hmm. I can negotiate with the buyer, but I will never negotiate or bargain with.
Wow, that's really wonderful.
So whatever I think is due to them, I will happily sort of give them.
Since Asad Bhai, you're actually in the apparel trade on an industrial scale, on a big scale. So after it should keep on it.
Yeah, it is a nice acting initiative. Mm-hmm. Actually, it can be related because, just in short, I say that why the name Gap? Mm-hmm. There was a gap, generation gap. Mm-hmm. Cover this gap, the gap actually formed. Mm-hmm. It's the beginning, 1969. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so where there is gap, we can fill up by this way. And I think what you've told, mm-hmm. this is one of the best way how we can fill this gap. Mm-hmm. Here. Mm-hmm. Here
wonderful.
And of course, you guys do a great job with the garment and all the women mm-hmm. who get employed. And
exactly. Yes. But artisans, it's a very good point that you mentioned. That itself is also another CSR. Right. The specific kibhabe.
Yeah, exactly. So it was really nice discussions we were having here. Sarah, it's really nice. Thank you very much. To be with us. So can you please share some specific steps that will help to achieve the agendas and the visions of Bangladesh? You are doing very fantastic right now.
So like for example, whatever that you said, if you can give a couple of specific ideas, right. Maybe what can be done for improving the life of the artisans, yes. And like maybe a couple of more specific ideas.
Right.
So, those would be ideas that we could also promote through Build as well on a bigger scale.
Yeah, I think, like I said, if more people started really employing them, if more people actually started mm-hmm. doing local work rather than spending that money in any case.
Yeah.
Now either I can, go abroad, go to India, Pakistan and get that stuff, mm-hmm. or I can have that, take a little bit of trouble, mm-hmm. do the designing, but have that, mm-hmm.
Promoting the local culture, promoting local fashion.
We can cite a relative example from Brak, the way the Arom. Mm-hmm. The way they source
I'm talking about, you'll be surprised that, see, it's not only the Nakshi Khata and that, right. even the older, mm-hmm. I'm sure you would be familiar with the old Bengali, mm-hmm. the Karchopi
world. Exactly, yes.
So that mm-hmm. is also our heritage. Right. It's not
true.
Like it's foreign. I don't believe mm-hmm. it's foreign.
True.
So I don't really work so much with the typical Bengali, Nakshi Khata, I don't do that, but mm-hmm. we do a lot of Zardozi and and Ari work, mm-hmm. which is maybe not traditional Bengali, mm-hmm. but I think,
That belongs to the whole...
It was very much, and the workmanship that we do,
it's amazing.
Is fantastic.
So that actually brings me to you, but since you are actually, you would be the buyer, of these kind of products. So what do you think? What is it going to take for most buyers to actually buy more local things so that Sara's vision can come true?
When I go for shopping, the thing that I first look at is, whether it everything in fashion, it doesn't necessarily have to fit into me. Mm. I may not carry it well. Mm. So I look at it, and I look at the local products, the local brands.
Right.
And also I find that, there are not many differences between this Indian and Pakistani dresses that we used to always buy and mm-hmm. online shopping and we used to...
Now our level has come up a lot.
Yes, mm-hmm. we used to go to Kolkata and buy lots of...
If the mentality is changed a little bit, a person starts thinking that I would rather buy a local
I always prefer
So basically you need to feel better about buying
Bangladesh. Yeah, exactly.
But right now I think it's the opposite. Mm-hmm. Oh, this is not from here, this is from there.
Yes, yes.
So, but that needs to change. So.
I think that's a wonderful note on which we can actually wrap our discussion up for today. I think, so basically in summary, the vision that Sara Karim has is for Bangladesh, where there will be more people buying local products and promoting local fashion, whereby actually the artisans, who are extremely highly skilled people but who often get neglected, their lifestyle and living conditions would also greatly be enhanced and improved. Mm-hmm. So, and we hope that from Build Bangladesh we would be able to contribute towards promoting, this is also a form of patriotism actually, and I think we would be able to promote that, and I think that would help us to also fulfill Sara's vision, which is, I think, all of our shared vision as well. And with that, we'd like to also present Sara a crest of appreciation and to thank you for actually, you know, accepting to be with us as an advisor.
Thank you so much.
So, Sara, why don't you maybe come in over here in the center?
Yeah. Thank you.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So, yes,
Let me read that now.
Okay. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for watching.